Hey guys, this is Grant Newhold with KCMC Sports, producing today for BlueFrame Technology, the Missouri State High School Basketball Championships. Wanted to give you an inside look at how we're doing that using production truck. Production is being held here at the JQH Arena in Springfield, Missouri, on the campus of Missouri State University. Here's a look at the producer's seat, courtside here, running production truck off of a Mac Mini. I have my input selected, cameras 1, 2, and 3, and I'm running all of that through the deck link capture box right there. I have audio coming in from 2 different sources, actually 3, one of them being this mixer here for the announcers to my left on headsets. I have another audio interface back here that's pulling in rim mic noise, so those are dedicated to the rim. And then I actually have a feed up high on the camera 1 position to capture a little bit more of the crowd sound. I find this software easy enough that when I'm running it, I can also run this camera that's courtside. It's very easy to sit and pan and run that camera while you're actually running the software, because you can switch cameras so easily with hotkeys, and you can clip replays so easy with a hotkey. And we can have up to 4 cameras plus the live output captured for replay, which always looks really, really good to put into the broadcast. Just as easy as that to select which cameras you want to replay. And ready to run replays right out of the gate. Highlights are easily clipped and put into Google Drive and shared with anybody who would need access to all of those highlights immediately. Our announcers down to our left have the program feed, which is very easy to set up and push out to 2 different locations. So we have a feed going there. We also have a feed going up there during game time. I run another laptop off to my right to keep track of brackets and live stats, because I can pull live stats right into my production with a simple graphic. Once the team stats are located from this computer, it's just as easy as typing them in right there. And so we can come to halftime stats pretty easily and put those in the broadcast. And that's really nice because they'll put those on the big screen. And we're punching that out to everybody that's in the arena to see the stats in a stat line like that. Just another benefit of how powerful this software really is. The other thing I've been doing is I've been shooting videos for pregame. And by that I mean I'm shooting videos on my phone and editing them and pushing them into a pregame. It's actually really simple if you know just a basic edit on your smartphone. So then I can actually Bluetooth, airdrop those from my iPhone to this Mac, grab them quickly, and actually add them to the broadcast. I've set them up in my replay tab because whenever I'm opening my broadcast, I like to open on my clips and having this play. And that's how I'll start the live. And then I can come over to the retap play and use this as a separate video player. I just need to make sure that this is full speed. And I also want to make sure that this graphics can be overlaid. And I'll show you why. I like to have my lower third locator come over the top of my graphic. I'll show you. So I would hit dissolve. Of course, we wouldn't want that on, but we would want this on. So this video is shot and edited on my phone, airdropped over to the production, And I can probably do that all with literally it's in 5 minutes of running out to shoot the footage, putting together an iMovie, and then dropping these graphics over the top once they're playing. So introducing key players, give a little beauty shot to the facility, and then we'll go from that and usually dissolve out to a live camera. And now we're ready to start live camera feed switching. So as you can see, production truck has a lot of capability built into it, especially as you start adding other components like shooting video and adding video so easily. It really adds and sweetens the broadcast a lot.